very high.
Welcome back. We do apologize for that hitch in sound. You're still watching the Pub Breakfast News Review with me, Fred Ndimuli, in studio with Dr. James Nikal, MP Seme, Ababu Namwamba, former MP Budalangi, Rosa Boy, woman representative Kisumu, and Karanja Kabagi, an advocate of the High Court, also a former candidate for MP under Jubilee Party ticket. And we continue looking at this issue of NASA saying they're not going back to court. They're using other means. And I'm sure when Dr. James Sikali wanted to react to what
I wanted to react. You see, what we said that Mr. Kabagi said that the court did not point out any illegalities or illegality by any particular person. And they said that the problem that the court found out was systemic issues. Now, that's where I come in. What are systemic issues? Systems that run or implement decisions of court or implement laws are made of people, are made of processes, are made of equipment. Now, if any of those is not working, then the letter of the law cannot be implemented. Now, what NASA said, there are certain people who are holding certain responsibilities, and under their watch, certain things did not work well, and the court proved that. It then becomes incumbent upon the system to know that so and so, we had a problem in this area of responsibility, therefore we don't think he can do this thing better now. Now, those are the things that NASA was saying. You cannot just assume that you are going to do it according to Article 140. That 140 must be broken down into systems.
Yes.
And systems include people and processes. And those are what we are pointing out. And now you say, why are we not going to court? When you have gone to court and the court has made a decision, and the person that is the executive arm that is to implement that decision has failed to do it, what guarantee do you have that even if you go to court again and then say, is then told do this, they'll do it?
So now, does that mean that you've lost faith in the court system?
Not in the court, in the executive arm.
But you're not going. Now, you're not seeking redress from the executive.
We are seeking redress at a higher level. And the higher level is the people.
Now, what it is this?
Yes. Let me just finish. I'm not finished. Then we also said that Akombe and Chebukati talked after we had made the decision. But the point then, that vindicated our position.
And don't you think that what Commissioner Akombe and what Chairman Wafula Chebukati said, that could form a basis for NASA to go back to court and seek redress on that point?
Can I just clearly state that we've not lost faith in the courts? What we've lost faith in is the execution of the court orders by the commission and by the independent institutions. For example, the court did order that elections should be held in 60 days, especially the way it's dictated in the Constitution. But the court ordered that election must be held according to the Constitution and the laws of the land. Now, my friend Ababu is sticking to the law and talking about the 60 days. We had no problem with 60 days. Our issue as NASA was according to the Constitution and the laws of the land. And that is where we came up with our reducible minimum, according to the law and the Constitution. We looked at what had happened, and we looked at why the election was nullified, and came out with issues that we thought would answer to that question.
Let me finish.
And when Ababu says that, why does NASA think that it has the people? It's the only one with the people. I'd like to look at Ababu and say this. Jubilee campaigned profusely and asked Kenyans to come out and vote for it. 38% of registered voters of Kenyans listened to Jubilee and came out to vote. And 62% of the people stayed at home and did not participate. And out of that 38%, which was largely Jubilee, even some of the Jubilee members who came out to vote still voted for Raila Molodi.
Yes,
knowing very well
yes,
that Raila was not a candidate.
Let me quote Buddha. Three things cannot for long be hidden: the sun, the moon, the truth. And the truth is this. Number one, NASA is going to court.
In fact, they've already instructed.
So you believe they're going to court?
They're going to court. I mean, it's an obvious fact. Only that they're not bold enough to go to court themselves. So they're going to go to court through proxy. They're going to approach the court through the back door.
Yet CEO Norman Maguire.
Let me proceed. I mean, you guys, you got to go have some decorum and courtesy.
Oh, come on. Work. Don't tell us about decorum.
Now, the other piece of truth is that, you know, this game of numbers, we need really to be serious here. On August 8th, out of 19 million registered voters, 4 million did not turn up. Because, you know, voting is not mandatory in this country, in this jurisdiction. It's not mandatory to go vote. 4 million people failed to turn up. On October 26th, what is significant is that a vast majority of the people who supported the president in August supported him in October. That is a reality that NASA keeps on running away from.
Okay.
And it's also a fallacy.
Let me interject onto that.
Let me just finish. I want to finish.
Allow him to finish that sentence.
Let me finish that point. It's a fallacy to imagine that the people who failed to turn up on October 26th are Raila supporters. Then I would ask these who failed to turn up on October 8th, the 4 million who failed to turn up on August 8th, whose supporters were they?
Okay.
Because really, it's a question of...
I'm assuming it's a rhetorical question.
We need to bring in Bana Karani.
Let me interject.
Dr. Terry, I'll let you...
You said we could interject.
You hear a statement like, we are now going to appeal to the...
To the people.
Now, I want to tell my good friend, Mheshimiwa Dr. Nyakil, just look at the Constitution at chapter 1
Article 1,
sovereignty of the people and the supremacy of the Constitution. What does it say? It says that the authority of the people shall be exercised through their elected representatives. Okay? And he has pointed out specifically how that is going to be happen, that will happen. And then you say that, oh no, we are now going to go to the people. But what you really need to ask yourself is this: how will you, having gone to the people, how will you now deal with the constitutional imperatives that says this is what has to be to happen? And I want to read to you the Constitution, exactly what it is talking about regarding the sovereignty of the people. They have sovereign power, and this Constitution is delegated to the following state organs.
Delegated.
Which shall, listen, the word perform, the word shall perform their functions in accordance with this Constitution. One, the Parliament and the Legislative Assembly of the county government, okay? The national executive and the executive structure in the county government. Three, the judiciary and independent tribunals. Four, the sovereign power of the people is exercised at A, the national level, and the county level, period. That is how, sovereignty, the moment, let me tell you, on the August 8th, you were elected through the people or by the people to exercise their sovereignty. The president, the governors, the senator, the distinguished woman rep here, all of you were elected. Now, what you're coming up with, a creature that doesn't exist. It doesn't exist.
Now, let me interject.
Let's allow him to interject.
What you have read, you haven't read it correctly, because it says directly or indirectly.
And the word is
directly or indirectly. What you have done is the indirect, and you started with the word delegation.
Yes.
Now, when you delegate, who has delegated? The people.
Yes. Let me
now,
answer that question.
I'll come next to honorable. I'm not finished. Then we are looking at a situation here where the denominator that is being used to work and turn out is what the Uhuru Kenyatta got on 8th and not the total number of people registered to vote in Kenya. That's a fallacy. When you are afraid of the total number of the people registered to vote, then you now use what I got in August.
It is not.
That
no,
cannot be.
Listen,
that cannot listen, be.
Lady and gentlemen, let's have it a bit orderly.
Can
I say, and we're looking at this headline on page 7 of the Daily Nation. NASA to use people to push for reforms.
Yes.
NASA seems to have a problem with the systems and the laws.
Yes.
What they're looking for now is a referendum and a push for a change in the laws.
Let me put it this way. When you delegate powers, I delegate powers to you. If I feel that you are not acting according to my wish, I am free to take back that power.
Let me respond.
And I'll support that point, yes.
The Constitution recognizes the people. And it says, it realizes, yes, when we say the people, these are more first group of people. But now, you go further and say, you structure how that engagement will be. And that's why we have the positions of the judiciary, the executive, the National Assembly, the County Assembly. Those are the people who are going to exercise those powers. And the Constitution is very clear. It says how. And that's why when you have a dispute, all right, you are supposed to go to the court. And the court will tell you the Constitution provides for the following. Just like NASA went to court. And it says this election of 2017, mm-hmm. August, were not held according to the Constitution.
Okay.
And the court listened to that.
I just want to address that point.
As you add, let me ask you this, because David Ndii, the NASA head of strategy, likened this assembly they're talking about to the Fungamano Initiative, this organization of civil society and religious groups that legally mandated the Constitution of Kenya Review Commission. And it had to be included in that process towards a constitutional review. Isn't that the same thing that NASA is talking about, that probably it's a review of the laws that they're seeking to have? It's only that they're starting
here. The absolute truth here is that NASA has been outfoxed. They have been outthought, outmaneuvered, outnumbered, and they're on a fishing expedition for salvation. Let me tell you, this constitution does not leave any space for doubt.
No.
This constitution is so clear.
Mm-hmm.
And when it talks about the in fact, at call 2.2, when it says no person may claim or exercise state authority except as authorized under this constitution, it is referring you back to the framework established in the exercise of state authority. And so even when the constitution talks about sovereignty of the people, it provides a frame within which that sovereignty is exercised through those three state institutions, both at the national level and at the county level. And even when it talks about direct exercise, again, there is a framework. That framework includes what the Constitution refers to, including measures like public participation.
Mm-hmm.
For instance,
yes.
in the enactment of legislation, Parliament is duty-bound to involve the people through public participation.
Mm-hmm.
When we have referenda, for instance, the people can come and participate directly.
Isn't that what
in decision
about?
No. Let me conclude.
Yes.
What NASA is talking about is extra constitutional measures. And indeed, I want to challenge my two honorable friends, my very good friends. If indeed you believe that this so-called People's Assembly is an alternative authority or an alternative measure of the exercise of the sovereign will of the people, then I challenge you right now on national TV, resign your positions in the national.
Just hold on.
This is fundamental.
Yes.
Because when the Constitution talks about either directly or indirectly, it does not say directly and indirectly. It says either or. So if you believe that a people's assembly, some amorphous organ styled as a people's assembly, is indeed a constitutional means of exercise of the sovereign will of the people, resign from
I'm
the national. Let me conclude.
Resign from the National Assembly today and join a people's assembly in Kisumu.
Then I'll come to the directly bit.
Talked about delegated powers.
Resign.
All these structures have powers delegated from or by the people to them, isn't it? That's what we've agreed on. I want these two lawyers to tell me, when the people feel that the powers they've delegated to these structures are misused mm-hmm. or not implemented mm-hmm. according to their will or according to their wish, do the people have an opportunity to recall this power?
Yes, yes, absolutely, absolutely. And it is provided for in the Constitution. You can recall.
Yes.
Okay, Rosa.
We can refer you to the Constitution.
Yes, can I continue?
On how it can be exercised.
So what is happening now is the people who Ababu thinks that NASA does not have feel that the powers they delegated have been misused, and they are taking their power back through these assemblies that we are going to form.
Now, let me answer this question.
No, my point is
this question needs to be answered.
You cannot refer to the people as amorphous. The people of Kenya are very well.
Let me clarify. I have to clarify this. The people are not amorphous.
They don't let me
finish. It's the structure.
When you talk, when you talk,
people cannot be amorphous.
We have used the power of the people to bring changes to the constitution when we came to the multi-party.
And that's what you're seeking to do.
And that's what we are seeking. And if you look at the statement that was made, it will involve other people, workers, religious organizations, civil society.
So the main thing you're seeking is a referendum, is a change in the laws.
We will look at what needs to be done.
What provision of the law?
The provision is Article 1 of the Constitution, which says directly, lobbying is allowed. Even demonstration is allowed under Article 37. Those are not illegal. When you
and
say we don't
that
feel...
that recognizes the sovereignty and of the people cannot be illegal.
No, let me finish. Okay. There are times when you feel that the law as it is, the constitution as it is, and the structures as they are being implemented are not meeting the will of the needs of the people. That is the time when you use the people directly, you get lobbying, mm-hmm. you get demonstrations, and to make your point. And when that point is made, then it'll be interred into the law. Now, look. When we change the constitution to multi-party system, this is what was used. When we got a referendum to change the constitution, this is what was used.
Yes.
When we came for the issue of devolution, this was used.
Now, how can you say this cannot be used because people are amorphous?
I don't like that.
First of all, it is absolutely not true that I call people cannot be amorphous. The people are people. And their sovereignty cannot be challenged. What is amorphous is these extra-constitutional structures mm-hmm. that NASA is now introducing. People's Assembly is not a constitutional structure. It's not recognized anywhere in the Constitution. This militia they launched the other day called...
What is this militia?
Resistance movement.
We're talking mainly about the People's Assembly.
The People's Assembly.
Let me conclude this. When you talk about the direct exercise by the people of their sovereignty, it's not the same thing as unleashing anarchy on the state. It's not the same thing as replacing
anarchy on its people, or the other way around.
Let's allow Bwana Namamba to finish this one. Go ahead, Bwana Namamba.
It's not the same thing as replacing democracy with mobocracy. In fact, NASA is attempting to replace our democracy with a mobocracy.
The rule of the mob.
But are we not unnecessarily demonizing a move that could actually help us resolve some of the issues we have? Seeking a referendum has to start from somewhere. A million signatures. Listen to my question. A million signatures, Bwana Kabage, have to be collected from somewhere.
That's where it's leading to Ababu.
But they tried to call.
Can you something? But I think it's important.
Collapsed. How many years ago? You are in ODM. Where are you now?
Let's listen to Bwana Kabage.
Listen. Let me tell you. This constitution, if you really look at it, it has a way out to whatever it is you want. For instance, if you go to chapter 16 on the amendment of the constitution, we have three articles: Article 255, Article 256, and Article 257. Article 256 talks about what is called parliamentary initiative, and Article 257 talks about the popular initiative,
yes,
where you involve people. Now, if my view is this, if NASA truly is faithful to the constitutional dispensation that we are talking about, you don't have to disrupt the lives of the people. You don't have to disrupt the lives of foreigners and the diplomats that are in this country by mounting this sort of street protest. What you need to do is this: avail yourself to what is the constitutional channel of amendment of the constitution. This so-called the People's Assembly, all right, is basically agitation to cause anarchy.
Do you have any route that you're using within the constitution to actually come up with this?
The root.
We are not lawyers. Yes.
The root is this. We are going to mobilize people. We are going to lobby people.
Yes.
That is allowed. Even that of demonstration is allowed in the constitution.
There was mention of using the county assemblies as well.
Which are representative of the people.
Just wait. I'll answer this. Then you can have people assemble. The right to people to assemble is also in the constitution. They cannot agree with that. Now if you look at what NASA is saying, I don't even think you listened or read what was said. What the issues we said that there's going to be a task force to look at systemic governance issues.
Mm-hmm.
And one of them is a systemic continuing failure of electoral bodies and electoral systems in general, the performance of national security organs and abuse there of the executive, the political structure and architecture and structure of parliament, in particular protection and safeguarding of the devolution. So we're actually looking at a broader view, people than just have capturing state power. And let me say, there's something in this country that even the most brilliant minds that we have here have not addressed themselves to. The difference between a state and a nation. What we are so concerned with is the state and capturing the state structures and state powers. Well, what this country really needs is this: the establishment of a nation where people believe and people know that I'm safe, there's justice for me, what I need will be addressed fairly, and so on. So that people have a belonging as Kenyans and not a belonging, not a feeling of exclusion. If we concentrate too much on state structures and capturing state power, the question they're raising
is that you're going outside the law.
Let
me just ask one question.
So how are you doing it within the law?
If they are concerned with the word assemblies or the word movement, now those, you can use any word. If you get people in Ufungan or Fungamano, as you used to do, that's
public participation cannot be against the law.
If you get people to sit in the rural areas, get them to sit and discuss this issue.
Okay.
These are assemblies. Now, when the time comes,
yes,
then we'll find, okay, this is what we think is agreeable in improving our constitution, our laws, our structure. Then we must, of course, take it into the structural system.
Our time is up, but I'll give each one of you an opportunity, about 45 seconds each, for your final remarks, final submissions. Let's start with you, Rosa.
I think what this assembly call for People's Assembly is an enhanced process of public participation, and that is enshrined in the law. Public participation cannot be wrong. What the fear from Jubilee is that the people want to reclaim back their processes, because their processes have been tampered with, their processes have been corrupted, so the people want to claim back their processes and take charge of these processes through public participation. Now, what Jubilee is scared about is when we are talking about the people, they just realized that they only have 38% of those people. So when 62% of the people come out to reclaim those processes, their processes, that is what makes Jubilee terrified.
Okay. Bwana Babu Namwamba?
The absolute truth here is that NASA has no constitutional root to what they're attempting to achieve. In fact, NASA has now clearly demonstrated that the Constitution is an obstacle to what they want to achieve. So they have to go outside the Constitution to be able to craft something that can work for them. They have boycotted an election, a very ill-advised move, and they have realized they just did a huge political error there. Now, what they are attempting to do is extra constitution, and there's no other explanation for it. If you want people to participate, there is a framework. People can recall the elected representatives.
Mm-hmm.
People can go to another election. People can make a verdict through a constitution. People can engage in public participation. All those are measures of people power within the purview of the constitution. There is nothing like people's assembly. There is nothing like resistance movements. All those things that NASA is grappling with picky-ponky, throwing all sorts of balls in the air is absolutely unconstitutional. And I want to repeat that as I conclude. If Rosa and Dr. Nyikal believe in this so-called People's Assembly, resign from the National Assembly now and join the People's Assembly of Kisumu County. Okay. So that then and you can contribute this through, I mean, out of the Constitution.
Thank you, Namwamba Bwana Karanja Kabali.
I want to make the following statement. One, Churchill said one day, democracy is the most difficult form of government, but there is no substitute to it. But that democracy is anchored in the Constitution. And the moment we do not faithfully follow the dictate, the letter and the spirit of the Constitution and the laws, then we slide to nothing but anarchy and become a failed state. That's the first thing I want to say. The second thing I want to say is, you know, history has very interesting lessons. I want to refer Kenyans to 1919, post Second World War, First World War. And I want to capture one country called Germany.
Because of time.
Yes, and I know. Yeah. And it is important for Kenyans who are listening to us, both the political players and the policy makers, to go and look at the YouTube and look at the history of the rise and the fall of Adolf Hitler. And look at characters like Joseph Goebbels, look at characters like Göring, look at characters like Himmler, and start seeing what happened to SS, which was a militia that was created by Hitler and his team to coerce the people, so-called. And what was the end of the process of what happened? So let us not try to make the mistakes of history that are clearly in our view.
Thank you, Bwana Kabage. Finally, Dr. Nyikal.
The lobbying and mobilization of the people to bring appropriate changes, even to the laws of the constitutions, is legal and constitutional. The wordings may not be palatable to some people, and those can be changed. But the basic principle of mobilizing the people to bring change is constitutional, and this country has used it. That is how we came from a one-party state to multi-party democracy. That is how we came with the new constitution. Mm-hmm. That is how we came with devolution. I do not understand why now, when NASA wants to use the same process to bring change in our electoral system, probably this is the last major change Kenya needs so that it can go peacefully onwards now on. Yes. Because we need a proper electoral system with a truly independent commission.
Okay.
To run the elections.
Okay. Word, thank you, Dr. James Nyikal. If I give you one last word, I'll have to give everyone else. Yes. Unfortunately,
one last point. Really. Yes. Just to say that.
Then I'll have 10.
Losing an election is not a crisis, and I really want to appeal to NASA, return to the constitutional framework, and then let us engage.
Okay.
From that. Just to finish, NASA did not lose any election.
Okay.
Jubilee went on an election on its own.
Wow. This one will keep going round and round. Thank you so much, Dr. James Nyikal, MP Seme, Ababu Namwamba, former MP Budelangi, Rosa Boy, woman representative Kisumu County, and Karanja Kabage, an advocate of the High Court and also member of the Jubilee Party. That has been my panel this morning. Very interesting discussions, and we'll continue having these discussions going forward. We are in for very interesting times. That deadline to challenge the results of the repeat presidential election lapses on Monday. After that, the Supreme Court has 14 days. What will happen to NASA after that? My name is Fred Indimuli, a paving way. Power Breakfast still continues. Next up, Chef Ali Mandri. Good morning.